Doesn't matter if you're stalled there, Ma. You adjusted your position then to get in. It happens like that. It's getting that sort of like when you're in a car, you have to adjust yourself, don't you? See, what would have perhaps stopped you from turning is if you got like, as you were turning like that, is to, it's this sweep stroke, yeah, put a sweep stroke at the back of the boat. So you've got three strokes really that you can use in that manoeuvre. You can use it for turning around, you see, because it's like a half, it's a turning stroke in many ways if you did it carried it full. And don't forget to use your feet to put pressure on the one side. So, if you did a trunk rotation, yeah, no, you can see whether your blade is in the right position. That's much better position, isn't it, than the blade? Yeah, but it's like you would be looking that way anyway, wouldn't you, with your trunk rotation? And then you would notice whether or not your blade's right or not, because you're looking that way. Right. Have another go across there and back and see. Has that helped? when you come back, Mark, make sure your paddle's on the downward side. So when you're coming back this way, you should be on your right side. Right. When you were paddling on the one side, were you on the downstream side? When you were paddling either way, and you were paddling on one side, were you on the downstream side of the boat? The paddle. Have another go and have a think about it. The downward side, if you're going this side, is left. If you're coming back the other way, yeah. Yeah, you corrected yourself there, that's fine. So, come back this way. What you have to do is make a decision really, Mark, what you feel comfortable with. So it's like saying, well, if you're drifting down, we are, so let's paddle back up. You look a lot more comfortable doing it that way. So, just continue that sort of part of that development, but also I would say work at your rudgering and that, because you never know. Yeah. We've all been there. Yeah. Yeah. We've all been there. Let's go. See that? Just keep the lower arm as straight as possible. The downward arm always straight. in a way, what you say, if you come forward like that, the other thing as well, what have you enjoyed so far with the session which Rich and I have done? Yeah. Was that happening last week, was it, or?
Yeah.
And it, today, how many of you? Well, that's progress, isn't it? Well, yeah, it's success. It's success, isn't it? So, what have you learned today different than last week, or the terminology being used? Yeah. Yeah. And that is part of the fundamentals which I haven't gone into, which normally when I'm in the pool I introduce people to that. And it sort of makes sense about what's actually happening with, you know, if you think of the three main B's are what? What are the three main B's? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, that's it. So it's whatever you do with those things there. Ultimately, if you do something that doesn't work, it's usually contributing to that. So what we've learned, what have you learned with the introduction of new strokes? What was the other key factor did you learn about the difference between the two? How does it help your confidence in a way?
You mean with that?
Yeah.
That strength? That didn't help with
my confidence. No. Yeah. So really, as I said to you before, do something if you're doing it well. Keep to that method, but don't be put off by trying something else as well. And it doesn't matter that you haven't mastered that, because it will, you know, in time if you practice it. Yeah. Okay. And what would you like to do next week as part of your development? Yeah. That's the target, because. Yeah. Yeah. Right, good. Yeah. That's essential what you've said there, to think of a positive.
Yeah.
And what you've got to think of a positive is that you've managed to go across there without coming out your boat. And that, in a sense, helps you to motivate yourself. I want to come back now.
Yeah.
Well, I hope that's been helpful, what Rich and myself. But I will go through the fundamentals with you. The trunk rotation is one of them. The other part is what they call connectivity. And the other one is feel, and the final one is posture, because they all interrelate, and if you have any of those out of place, that has been the reason why something hasn't been so successful. Yeah. Well, the thing, what the movement where you're conscious of doing something, the next part of that learning is what we call creating patterns. So creating patterns is like the patterns of learning and patterns of related to your blade strokes, how your boat reacts, and how your body reacts. And it's like once you start joining those patterns up, it's the, when the improvement starts to take place. If you are coming out of the boat, you're doing something that is the next part of learning. And so if it's the next part, it is because you haven't quite grasped, you know, it's all to do with what I've just said, really. I suspect not. Basically because I'll switch this up.